netminder Jake Allen wearing a special mask tonight on our Veterans Day. Also to celebrate Veterans Day, Darren Pang is standing by with former Blues goalie and Lieutenant Colonel of the Canadian Armed Forces, Ed Stanowski. Panger?
Well, thank you very much. Pleased to be joined by Ed Stanowski on such a special evening here. When we look at the history of a goaltender, Ed played 219 games in the NHL, many with the Blues. I bet nothing could prepare you for what you went overseas for, but maybe goaltending helped out a little bit, Ed.
It did, Darren. It did. You know, there's a lot of similarities between what you have to do to be successful in hockey, especially professional hockey. You know, the camaraderie, the teamwork, leadership that you need, you know, the dedication, the hard work. Military is the same way. You know, all of these young men and women who are at the game tonight and serving all over the world right now and probably watching this, you know, overseas via satellite, they've got that same genre. That's how they do business. They depend on their teammates and go out there and do a hard job.
So when you left the NHL after the 10 seasons, did you take a little bit of time before you enlisted?
I did. I took about a year and played my last game in the league, and it was about a year later I was an officer cadet on a parade square doing drill and worked through my basic training and went on to have a 29 great years. I really enjoyed my time in the military.
And Lieutenant Colonel.
That is correct. Yes, I went the officer route and had the privilege of going on operations with the American and the Canadian Armed Forces, alongside the Americans, but in the Canadian Armed Forces. Saw some great things by some great young Americans, some great Canadians all over the world. I'm happy to have done it.
One of the things that you did see is the Stanley Cup, and whether it be in Kandahar or Afghanistan. Tell us a little bit about that, because that's fascinating, and I'm sure that gave everybody a little bit of enjoyment away from the battle.
Well, it was pretty special and pretty exciting. The Stanley Cup went to Afghanistan in 2007. I received a phone call from Canada's Chief of Defense Staff, Rick Hillier, and he said, at the time I was serving in Canada, and he said, is there any way we could maybe get the Stanley Cup and take it over and let the troops see it? So I made a call to New York and talked to the folks there and Mr. Bettman, and they all supported it. We put it on a Hercules, C-130, and flew it into Kandahar. And the troops went absolutely wild over it. And a number of the alumni went also with it. And it was pretty special.
Well, you're obviously wearing a poppy. I think for many Americans, as we celebrate what gets done overseas, in Canada, the poppies get sold. We've got a poppy right here and celebrating Flanders Field and the Great Poem. Maybe you could describe the proceeds that get towards the veterans.
Certainly. Yeah, the poppy is somewhat of a universal symbol. I saw it being passed out here in St. Louis in a couple of the stores here too. So it's somewhat universal, and it's it dates to the Great War, the First World War. And you know, there's a tie to that also to hockey, and that a lot of people forget there was a lot of young men in Canada and the United States in 1914, 15, 16, 17, who put down their hockey sticks and picked up a rifle and went over to Europe and did the business. And in 1918, where coming through up on the 100th anniversary of the armistice, mm-hmm. and the poppy is a reflection of that also. So it's a good thing. It's a good reminder. You'll see, certainly in Canada today, a lot of people wearing a poppy.
Well, thank you for all that you do and everybody. I know it's going to be a special night here in St. Louis. It's great to see you. It's a pleasure being with you, Ed.
Always good, Darren. Thanks very much.
Thanks very much. Fellas?